Hello, I am Dr. Sriram Ramalingam, Medical Director and Chairman, Pradya Netralaya, located at Artinagar, Bangalore, specialized in cataract, refractive surgeries, glaucoma, and squint. Refractive errors in the eye may be in the form of myopia, hypermetropia, or astigmatism. The treatment of these refractive errors usually are either glasses, contact lenses, or maybe in the form of laser correction, or last is what is called as ICL. Now, glasses and contact lenses are given in younger patients. Suppose a person does not want to wear these glasses, there are laser corrective surgeries available in the form of either LASIK, LASEK, or what is called as a PRK or occasionally called as EPI LASIK. These corrections or these laser corrections can be done only after the person is around 20 to 21 years of age. The refractive error has been stable for at least 6 months and the diagnostic test like pentacam or topography are suitable for the patient to undergo these laser corrective surgeries. The most commonly performed corrective surgery or refractive corrective surgery is what is called as LASIK. In LASIK, a microkeratome or a femtolaser surgical device is used to create a small flap. This flap includes the outer portion of the eye, which is called as the epithelium, and also this part of the stroma. The flap is reflected and a laser is done on the corneal bed or the corneal stroma, and the flap is put back again. Since there is a flap is put back, there is no need for bandage and this heals fast. So this is what is called as a LASIK refractive surgery. LASIK refractive surgery is suitable for patients who have got a suitable corneal thickness and the corneal bed is sufficient after the LASIK procedure. Suppose the corneal thickness is not suitable for a LASIK surgery, then one can go for a LASEK surgery. In LASEK surgery, only the superficial epithelium is just rolled back using an instrument. And this laser is done on the stromal bed. And the epithelium is rolled back onto the stromal bed again. So there is the thickness of the flap remains very thin. The corneal bed remains a sufficient thickness. LASIK procedures are suitable for patients who have got a thinner cornea but still can undergo laser procedures. So this is the basic difference between LASIK and LASEK. In LASIK laser, the flap thickness is little thicker, whereas in a LASEK, only the epithelium is taken and is rolled back again. The advantage of both the procedure is a laser can be done in this stromal bed without compromising on the corneal thickness. So this is the basic difference between LASIK and LASEK. The surgeon will decide which treatment is suitable for you based on your corneal thickness and based on a pentacam or a topography analysis.